Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today we're gonna talk about JIB, and this is a containerized tooling from Google, so you can build your Docker images using a very nice tooling. And this is something that I run through and I saw it on Google's blog and I thought this sounds really amazing and I want to try it out and I want to look at it and play around with it. And I hope that this will showcase it in a good way for you and that you are getting excited to actually build your Docker images using JIB. So to look into this, we have two different ways of running JIB. Either you run it with Maven or with Gradle to package your images. And I use Maven usually, so I will show that example. But I think most of the things that I will show will work fine in Gradle as well. So if we look at the configuration of this Maven, because this is a Maven plugin and it has some configuration, we will look at the Maven setup a little bit later. But this configuration is quite involved. You can do a lot of interesting things here. First off, you can say that you want to build this from a specific image. And I guess it needs to be an image that both have Java and has some kind of system on it. So in this case, you said that I want an Alpine image from OpenJDK, and that's a very small image. You can also say where you want to put it. You can either put it on some local resource. If you have a container registry locally, you can put it on the Amazon cloud. They have some good credential helper for at the Amazon cloud. You can put it on the Google cloud. They have credential helpers for that as well. Or you can use your own credentials in order to put them up on your own little container registry, or you can also push it to your local Docker. So you have a lot of options there. And when it comes to the container, you can say that you want some flags for your Java, if you need to have specific flags for more memory, or if you want to run it in debug mode, or if you want to set a specific flag to set some credentials in your actual image, or anything like that. You specify a main class, and this is to show what you want to run in your image. And then you can put some more arguments that you will give to your main class, so you can run different things in different images if you have packages that way. You can say that some specific ports should be distributed to the world, so these are ports that should be opened from inside of the Docker environment and out. And you can also specify that you want them to be UDP. You can use ranges, and you can also tell it that this is going to be an OCI format if you like. So there's a lot of interesting things that you can configure, but you don't need to actually configure that much. I will show that as well. I will try to do this on the Google Cloud and locally. And to do it on the Google Cloud, you will install this Docker Credentials GRC. So you get the Google Container Registry credentials logged in on your machine. And then you just run this Docker Credential GRC, GRC login. And that will log you in locally. So the current console is actually logged into the cloud, so you can push things to the cloud. And then you just run compile JIB build, and that will push it to the cloud. Or you can do compile build Docker build, and that will build to your local Docker environment. So that's two different ways you can build. And if you want to set up some credentials your own way, you can use this setup where you tell which what the server name is or the server ID, and then username and password to specify that. But if you're using the container registry on Google, you use this other method. If you use Amazon, you have their credential manager, and you can also push to the local, and then you don't have to set up these credentials at all. But if you need credentials, these can be put in the settings XML in your local directory, or in the configure directory for Maven, you can also put these settings. But look more at the Maven specification where you put your settings if you need to do that. And if you need to have a password in Maven, it's good to know that you can also use the Maven command encrypt master password and your password. So you store local password encrypted, so you don't get that problem that they are easily read by any process. And I also have some small helper functions down in this README, so you can remove all images after you have tested this. Don't run this in production. It's only to prune out all your images after you have actually run this test. So let's look at the POM file to run this in the Google Cloud, because I'm running a Windows machine. I can't actually push it to the local Docker because of the limitation that I haven't found Docker running in Windows. I guess there are some implementations for that as well. We can also look at this little program here. I just did a very simple Hello World program. I wanted to create something to see how large the container would be, not how have an involved program that takes up a lot of space. I just want to see how this is containerized. So this is my little POM file here. I have the member Maven assembly plugin, so I can build and test this out without actually packaging it to the cloud. And then I have this Maven plugin for release. So this is built on my versioning demo. If you find that online, you can use that as well. So that's to release multiple versions of this project. And then we have this cloud tools that JIB is a part of. And I use 0.9.7, and probably there will be a new version when you see this video. And then I say that I want to put it on the Google Container Registry IO. I have this project up there, and then I want to create an example Docker image there, and I want to use the credential helper of GRC. So that was what we talked about earlier. And I have also put in this execution part here. So you can actually say that during the execution of the goals, the standard goals, you should look at the phase of package. And in that phase, you should run the goal build. And if you are running the goal build, as we saw earlier, it will push it to the Google Cloud Container Registry. So if we run either package on this Maven repository, or we run this command jib build, it will build it to the container registry online. We don't want to look at it building because it takes some time. But when you're done, you will actually get a container up in the cloud. So these are all my images under jib example. And here we see that I have a Docker manifest schema 2, and it's 44.8 megabytes. And they say that this is built on distribution less deployment. So this is, I guess, Google's own little Docker image to run Java in the cloud. And as you see, it's very small. And you can deploy it to Google Cloud Engine and actually run it, and it works fine. So this is a very nice, and it's very fast to start up and running. So it's a very nice way to push your builds to the cloud. And if we look at my virtual box here, I have a similar setup, but the POM file is a bit different. Here you see that I have a little two image here, so I actually have the name of the image is the same. This I could have changed, and I will get a different name locally. So this is the name it will create when I actually run this on this machine. So we can actually go in here and change it. Let's go into the POM file, and let's give it a reasonable name for this image. Let's call it jib test, and Explorers. And there we go. So in the same way here, I also have the phase package, but the goal here, instead of build, I run Docker build, and that will push it to my local environment. So let's do a package here, and I will skip forward so you can see the result when it's done. And now we have built this little Docker image. You see here that it gets the GRC distroless Java Docker image, and it builds dependencies, classes, layers, resources, and finalizes it, and then loads it into the Docker demon, and it gets this name JIB test explorers. So if we do Docker images, we will see this image on my local Docker environment. So this is the last or next to last here. And as you see on my local Docker image, it's 118 megabytes instead. So I guess that some of the resources used in this image is packaged in the Google Compute Engine, so you don't have to package them into your Docker build. But as I'm running it locally, it will have need all those resources, so it will be a little bit larger. Another interesting thing here, you see that this was built 48 years ago, and you might wonder, why does it actually say the specific 48 years ago? And that's because they probably missed on setting created date, so they set the creation date to zero. And if you look at the Unix timestamp, zero means 1970, the 1st of January, 0000, in the middle of the night on January the 1st on the 1970s. And that's 48 years ago. So that's why you will get this very weird result when it was created. This JIB tooling is still not 0.1, so they're still working on it, but I think it has a lot of potential, and the build seems very stable. It works every time. It was a little bit of a hassle to actually figure out how to work with it and actually get it pushed to the cloud, but after you install the tooling and read up a little bit about it, it was very straightforward. So I hope that you found this video interesting. I hope that you are excited for this tooling and that it will give you some extra boost in your day-to-day life or work. I hope that you like this video. Give it a like, share it with your friends and colleagues. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. And I really hope to see you in the next video.